Right. This is a new setup for me. If you follow my channel, you recognize this as my home photography studio. But regarding lighting, I've just received a new video light, which you can use as well for photography, and a huge reflector, light diffuser, dome, however you're gonna call it. It's super big, but guys, as bigger, the best, because it's more flattering in the skin of your subject. So for portrait photographers, this is gonna be very useful. Make sure to subscribe to my channel because I'm gonna do the second part of that video everyone loved about how to set up a home photography studio in a very affordable way in a small place. But in this second part, I'm gonna talk more in depth about the products, which are super, super affordable for everyone, I promise you that. But I'm gonna talk about the differences between continuous light, flash, and different light diffusers, because everyone is asking me this through Instagram and in the comments on YouTube. And you know, guys, I always reply, so please feel free to comment below and I will solve all your doubts in that video. Anyway, today we're gonna talk about how to make money with your camera. Your camera is a money-making machine. I promise you that. You just have to learn how to do it and how to evolve. And I know it's very hard as a beginner, and that's why I'm gonna tell you 7 rules you have to follow, like 100%, or you're not gonna be able to make money with your camera ever. And this is very focused on beginners because we all struggle with the same things, and I've been there myself. So now you heard me talking about this to you guys, but it's because every single thing I wanna talk about, I did those mistakes myself. So make sure to watch to the end and you take notes to don't do those mistakes. Rule number one, stop approaching photography as a hobby. Yes, I'm sure you are smiling a bit because I'm sure you are doing it. I did it as well, and I think it's one of the hardest things to overcome as a photographer. At the beginning, I was like working as a hobbyist and I was making 50 quid here, 50 quid there. I was losing money. You lose more than 50 quid when you shoot with someone. First of all, it's the time, the travel expenses, your editing software, because you have to pay for it, and your equipment. So make sure you stop approaching photography as a hobby and start charging. The rule number two would be to make a portfolio. I'm sorry, you're a beginner, you are a bit stuck, you don't know how to approach clients. Don't approach clients if you don't have a portfolio. I don't care in which niche you are working on. If you're a portrait photographer, just make sure you make a nice portfolio. You can use your friends, you can use your family, you can use models and do collaborations. There is so many people out there who want pictures for free. So if you don't have a portfolio, maybe, you know, like hang out with some friends or meet people on Instagram in your area and exchange services. There is new models out there that they will post happily for you to get photography in exchange. So do that, make sure you do a portfolio within your niche. For example, in landscape, same thing. You can travel around locally and take some landscapes and then do a portfolio about landscape photography. Product, the same thing. You don't have any client with product photography. Just shoot products at home. Take your jewelry. I don't know, whatever you have at home. If you wanna shoot fashion, just take your clothes and shoot product photography or flat lace or fashion photography. Food photography products. Just make sure you do a portfolio before you approach anyone. Because the mistake people does is sending their Instagram or their website to someone and you don't have good pictures. So make sure, even if they are not too good or they are average, make sure, you know, you follow one niche and then you have something to show to the future client. So making a portfolio is crucial and it's for free. So you should definitely do that before approaching anyone. Rule number three, start charging. I don't even know how many people text me regarding this, and I did the same, guys, I did the same thing, the same mistake. I wasn't charging. It was a friend, no, don't worry, I'm just learning. Ah, don't worry, just this, I charge you 10 pounds or nothing. Don't do that. Start charging, because the moment you're gonna start charging, you're gonna lose the fear to actually charge to everyone. Just because you are a beginner doesn't mean you cannot charge. I mean, be honest with your level. I'm not gonna tell you charge 200 quid if your photography is very, very basic. But there is people of all kinds. Of course, you're not gonna approach a big brand or a big client with a lot of quality content on Instagram, for example, and offer your services when you don't have quality enough to improve their photography. So be honest with your level and approach clients you know they need you. There is so many micro brands out there and their photography is very bad or with the phone. So if you honestly think you can improve their photography, offer your services and then charge accordingly. Don't charge like a lot of money, because obviously if you don't deserve that money because of your quality or experience, they're not gonna book you basically. But if you are quite cheap and affordable, you're gonna be able to charge and lose the fear. So at least charge a flat rate to don't lose money. This is the minimum you can do. Guys, you have to break the barrier of charging. And this is very hard, I know that. I've been there for years and then I was charging very little and I regret so much. I mean, I don't regret because I've learned. And with mistakes, you learn. So you're gonna do a lot of mistakes because it's unavoidable, but you can avoid them, please do, and start charging. Rule number four, approach clients. We all think at the beginning, even sometimes now I'm a bit lazy myself because people find me and they book me. So lately I'm quite surprised, like I'm getting booked quite often and I don't even look for the clients. So this is very good for me. I can't complain at all. But guys, as a beginner, you have to chase people. You cannot do like SEO in your website or posting in Instagram with hashtags and wait for people to find you. You have to approach people and this takes time, but you can do it. So make sure you approach your ideal client. If you have one niche, follow people in that niche and then find clients with the level of photography that matches your level. But this is super important. Start sending DMs on Instagram, LinkedIn, or wherever you are hanging out in social media, but approach clients. And I'm gonna link down below. I shared a time ago, but maybe you are new here. I do have an email template to approach brands and clients. You can grab it down below, it's for free. And this is gonna be gold for you guys, because at the beginning, for me, my barrier was, I don't know how to approach a client. I don't know what to tell my client. I don't know how to introduce myself. So this email template is gonna help you a lot and it's for free. So many of you guys thank me already, so you are welcome. Obviously, you're gonna have to change it. I put some notes as well in the email template for you to know and to read, but you're gonna have to adapt it to the client or the brand. I'm gonna do another video about this as well, but this is super important. Take that email template and adjust it and start approaching people. Rule number five, approach people with the right portfolio. I mentioned this time ago, but I can't stop saying it and I will keep saying it. Also, a mistake I did. I used to have like, because I shoot within different niches. I'm a portrait photographer. I love portrait photography so freaking much, but I love all kind of categories really because I love photography and it's a challenge for myself and you become a better photographer as well, experimenting through other categories as well. But make sure if you are contacting a product photography client, for example, for food, don't send them an Instagram or a website where you have landscape photography, a picture of your mom, a picture of your brother, nobody's gonna book you. So if your Instagram or website has that kind of content, but you're gonna approach product photography clients because you have the knowledge, make sure you do a PDF with just product photography pictures. So you go straight to the point and that client is gonna be, okay, this is their photography quality and this is what I can expect from that person. And that's it. Because nowadays people don't have time and people gonna scroll through your email or DM on Instagram and they wanna see something super quick. So don't make them go through your pictures. Make sure you follow one niche and then you send the right portfolio to them. Rule number six, be versatile with your photography. There is so many photographers, they get in the head and they are so stubborn and they wanna focus in just one niche. This is beautiful, you should. You have to find your niche and know what you like the most. This is fine completely. But you are versatile and more at the beginning, you're gonna be able to land more gigs. For example, I'm a portrait photographer myself, but during the lockdown, I was shooting a lot of product photography. If I wouldn't have that experience shooting product photography and that knowledge, I wouldn't have any money. I couldn't pay my bills. I couldn't pay my rent in London, which I promise you is freaking expensive. So guys, if you have more versatility and you're gonna be able to shoot within different niches, you're gonna be safe. Because when things go to hell, like during the lockdown and you cannot shoot with people, you can shoot product photography. So I was having my products sent home and then I was shooting at home without having to see anyone or my client. Then I send the products back, sometimes I keep them and they pay me. So this is very useful for you. And with time, if you have a lot of work within your niche, fine, just stick to that niche. It would be amazing. But when you are a beginner, it's very, very good if you can shoot different things because that's gonna give you money. I do have a video about this, about how to make money with product photography at home. So make sure you watch it if you are into it because it's a very good way to make money. And now everyone needs product photography because after the lockdowns, everyone is doing like new businesses, new websites, e-commerce websites, and this is very useful. So many of you loved it. So please make sure you watch it. Rule number seven. This rule is one of the most important ones because, guys, when you become a better photographer, so many people get lazy. They get lazy, it's like, okay, I'm making money already. Guys, you have to get better. I think I'm more stressed now about learning new things than even before, because I want to get better and better and better. Because if you learn more, you can get paid more. You can increase your fee. If you have more knowledge, it's more reputation as a photographer, and it's more creative background. So make sure you always keep learning and improving yourself. Regarding equipment, because you can start with little. I'm not telling you the opposite. Start with little. But then when you are there, make sure you improve your skills. I'm gonna talk about two platforms, and I think you heard me about this in one video. And there is no excuse for you to sign up, because they have free trials. So at least get the free trial, use it, because you're gonna be able to do courses for free. And then if you don't like it, don't pay for it. But at least try them, and I'm sure you're gonna love them. One of them, you heard about it for sure, because everyone on YouTube is promoting it, but I promise you it's worth it, is Skillshare. What I did is join the free trial. You're gonna have a link down below where you can sign for free, and you're gonna have, I don't know if it's 1 week or two, you're gonna have to check it out, but still, during that time, you can do all the courses you want. So you don't have an excuse to don't do it, because it's free. So you have all kinds of courses there, and if you wanna grow as a photographer, you're gonna have there, for example, in my situation, I do pay for it. I took advantage of the free trial and then I stopped. It's like, I didn't wanna pay. But then because I'm learning now video and marketing, you're gonna have to learn marketing to promote your business. I'm always coming back to Skillshare. So now I pay because the annual pass is under $10 and I'm all the time there, to be honest. I don't even watch Netflix. Very rare if I watch Netflix. I like to feed myself with tutorials, social media marketing, so many things I need to know to grow my business, because it's not just about photography, it's about the marketing side of it and promote yourself. So Skillshare is very good. Try it down below and let me know in the comments what do you think about it. And the second one, this one I discovered during the pandemic, during the first wave, let's say, is Creative Life. And if you are a creative person, you're gonna freaking love this platform, because there is a lot of courses there for every single niche, for beginners, for more advanced, for average photographers, all kinds of niches. And you have free lessons every single day. And this is unlimited. So free lessons, not free courses. This is different. There is courses and they have a lot of lessons, and then you have one for free every day. I think I did this for 3 months. I was like, okay, free lesson today, free lesson tomorrow. And then I loved it so much that now I pay monthly, because it's insane. They have big, big, big photographers to teach you, like incredibly big. I recommend you, you're a portrait photographer, to watch Lindsay Adler. She's incredible, she's huge in the industry. She shoots for Vogue magazine, Harper's Bazaar, Elle magazine, and she's super creative in the studio. And if you see her, you will see why I love her, because I love lighting, you know that, guys, and I love to play with lighting in the studio, and she's incredible. So take that course if you want. The good thing about Creative Life is you can pay monthly and you have all the courses, or you can buy individual courses and they are super cheap. To be honest, for me, it's worth to pay the monthly because it's similar price to pay one course. But just so you know, you have that possibility. And the second course I love is the course from Joy L. That guy is incredible, the course. You're gonna learn a lot about lighting. He's a commercial photographer. He shoots for films and for a lot of commercials, but it's incredibly amazing and the quality is top. I promise you that. They are very well made, divided by chapters, and you're gonna love it. So those two are the main sources of knowledge I take from. It's the only two platforms I pay, I think, because in the end of the day, you end up paying a lot of subscriptions, but these ones are worth it for me because it's knowledge and I always love to improve myself. I'm gonna put as well the link down below, so go check them out. And these 7 rules are the first ones you have to follow. There is many more, obviously, but these 7, they're gonna put you in the right path to be a good photographer and make money with your camera. If you have any questions, again, text me on Instagram, comment below. I always reply to my comments, at least now I still can. Hopefully one time I'm not gonna be able because I have so many subscribers. So please make sure to subscribe and give a thumbs up to the video because it helps me a lot. And I will see you very soon again, guys.